You were, of course, based in England for a large part of your professional career, but your, you know, the fact that you're Swedish was a very, very important part of your identity. You won 4 Davis Cup titles. That was a tournament, you know, that you prioritized always in your career. The chance to play for a team and represent your country. It's not something that we see in the modern game, do we?
No, we don't. I mean, times has changed, and it was of great importance for all the Swedish players at the time. And I think for most of the top players during the 80s to represent your country, playing a team which was a little bit different. It was a different atmosphere, but it was nice, you know, being with a group of people. You can sort of help and support each other. And obviously we had a lot of success in Davis Cup. It's quite demanding as well, because it takes at least 4 weeks out of your schedule every year. Well, I used to play Davis Cup and I played 6 finals in a row. That means starting the season in January and finishing in December. Once the Davis Cup was out of the system, it was a new year starting again. So I had 6 straight seasons basically without too much rest. And perhaps that was part of the reason why I stopped so early at 30 years of age. I felt in a way a little bit burnt out mentally, I think, because having spent so much time and maybe not having enough time to rest. Because if you look nowadays, you know, people, they keep on playing here past their 30s and they're being successful. But I guess during my time, once you were at 30 years of age, your chances of winning Grand Slam was very, very little. So, you know, I took the opportunity to maybe go at the right time.
We've just witnessed the end of the Winter Olympics. You were, of course, a part of 3 Olympic Games yourself. You won the gold medal in 84 when it was just a demonstration sport, 2 bronze medals in 88. And then, you know, I thought was a rather remarkable moment in 1992 when you were and still are the only tennis player from your country to be the flag bearer at an Olympic Games. It's quite remarkable considering the number of great tennis players that Sweden has produced over the years, especially in the 80s and the 90s.
I think the timing was right. Borg, you know, tennis was not part of the Olympics, of course, during his time. Otherwise, I think he could have been the one here. That was my 3rd Olympics. Had some medals in Seoul, and in 1992 I was basically ranked number 1 in the world and had a lot of success, and I had a question, and a very honorable question, to get to carry your flag. That was quite an experience, actually, to walk out there with a flag. What I do remember from that is quite funny, because it's the preparation before you get out. We had to wait in a tunnel. It was quite crowded and it was so hot. It was like 35, 40 degrees in this tunnel. I had my suit on and the tie, and I was sweating like mad. So it was quite refreshing when you can get out of the tunnel and actually walk around there. So I do remember it very much.